I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now. We begin in Los Angeles, where a Filipina is one step closer to making history with a projected win in the city council race. The rainy Los Angeles weather could not dampen city council candidate Ysabel Jurado's victory party this past week. As of March 26, Jurado was leading the race with 8,611 votes, nearly 400 more votes than incumbent Kevin De Leon's 8,214, while Assemblymember Miguel Santiago's 7,464 votes trailed in a distant third. The stage is set for a November runoff election between Jurado and De Leon. Jurado could make history as the first Filipino to hold the Los Angeles City Council post.
It's absolutely making history. We've never had a Filipino get this far in a city council election.
Jurado, a political newcomer, believes winning against established politicians shows that the district, which includes parts of northeastern Los Angeles and stretches into downtown LA, is ready for new leadership. While the majority of the votes have been counted, the final count is scheduled for March 29, and certification will take place shortly after that. Let's head to the East Coast, where Fil-Am Steven Raga is seeking a second term in the New York State Assembly. After a successful first term in office, New York State Assembly member Steven Raga, the first Filipino-American to win an elected position in New York government, is running for a second term.
It's been highly successful. It's been historic. We've had first-time investment in our community. We've had a collaboration of other elected officials who want to support the Filipino-American community. Raga,
Raga, Raga. Among his achievements, helping secure a $1.6 million grant to help build a Filipino community center in Queens. Raga also introduced a bill that would make the local government more transparent and to make it easier to access public records, not just for journalists, but for all New Yorkers. The New York State Assembly primary elections is scheduled for June 25th, while the general election is set for November 5th.
And finally, we head back to California in San Francisco, where the life of legendary Fil-Am labor leader Larry Itliong is told in a musical.
The story of famed Filipino-American labor leader Larry Itliong is told through song and dance in Larry the Musical. He was known to have organized and led protests in the 1930s for equal pay and dignified living conditions for farm and cannery workers throughout the West Coast and Alaska, up until the formation of the United Farm Workers in 1966. The musical is based on the book Journey for Justice, The Life of Larry Itliong, by the late Dr. Don Mabalon and by Gail Romasanta, who is a writer and the executive producer of Larry the Musical.
What you're gonna see is dance, you're gonna see choreography, you're gonna see singing. Filipinos love to sing. We have such amazingly talented singers. You're gonna see script, you're gonna see movement. And so those tangible things that we can see ourselves and really feel the history, that we've never been able to just sit back and see the history and all of its joy, because our people are super funny and resilient.
Larry the Musical runs until April 14th at the Brava Theater in San Francisco. For more details, visit LarryTheMusical.com.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Stay with us, Kapamilya.